Excuse me, sir, but this card has also been declined. Oh man, that takes me back. July 13th, 1993. I'm in Indianapolis, Indiana, there to negotiate a deal with Eli Lilly for the development of a non-invasive glucose monitor. I was there at dinner, the Peterson Steakhouse. I had just consumed a marvelous peppercorn cream sauce on a filet when the waiter politely and discreetly informed me that the third card I'd given him had been declined. What I knew at that point was that all eight were now overdrawn. $45,000 and a job that paid $20,000. That's what one calls a dark moment. How did I get in that dark moment? Well, the reality is I have an obsession. And that obsession is associated with light measurements. And light measurements are very unique. They have the ability to determine who you are by simply putting your hand over a flashlight, to tell if you're sober, to tell if you have a disease. So I want to share with you my obsession of using light measurements to make the world a better place with products that can change how we interact with the world. That process began following graduation from Stanford, and it was fueled by an internship with the first company to develop non-invasive oximetry, measuring oxygen non-invasively. That led to research and the first ever peer-review publication on non-invasive glucose monitoring. That triggered this article in the Wall Street Journal and created a lot of interest surrounding what we were doing. That then led to that dark moment I was talking about. I got rescued from that dark moment by my business advisor. He picked up dinner. He gave me a little more money. And what we did do is we eventually went and negotiated with the top three companies in current technology glucose monitoring and eventually selected J&J as our partner. And here's the picture following the signature of that. What's important now is we had the money to now pursue this obsession. We had a small team, we got started. And over the next 8 years, I tell you, we worked our asses off. It was unbelievable. We had a lot of fun, we assembled a great team, and we developed a prototype that measured glucose non-invasively. And in 2003, at the J&J Investor Forecast, they announced that they were going to commercialize non-invasive glucose monitoring. My dream was almost there. And by the way, I kind of thought my vacation home in Telluride was right around the corner. But you know, we're now back at another dark moment. And what happened was 14 months after that announcement, we were fired. Fired. And I think about that today, and I have anguish. I feel pain in my stomach. Because what happened is, at that juncture, I had to dismantle my life's work and fire people that had recently been in my wedding. But this is where an obsession comes in. An obsession is motivating, and it motivated me. And we began to dig and dig. And when we hit bedrock, we were too stupid to know it was bedrock, and we kept digging. And out of that emerged four entities that exist today, and I want to talk briefly about those. The first is Luminime, and it makes fingerprints that work. They work anywhere, anytime. All of us today have keys in our pocket, right? Why? There's a unique biometric on your finger. Why don't you use that to get in your car, your house, your office, your computer? You can. The technology that's going to allow that to happen is coming forward. And in fact, if you've been to Walt Disney World in the last 5 years, you put your finger on one of our devices. Hong Kong immigration, the same. And if you work in the medical profession dispensing drugs, you've used one of our devices. And I'm excited to say, in 2014, you buy a car, you're going to be able to buy one with one of our biometrics on it. Really cool stuff. You now see that light measurement obsession becoming reality. I want to talk briefly about TrueTouch, non-invasive alcohol measurements. This is from the MAD website, and it communicates two things really well. The first is drunk driving is still a problem. We're 1 year away from the 10th year anniversary of the 9/11 tragedy. In that 10-year period, 120,000 people have died due to DWI. A quarter of the population of Albuquerque. 40 times more than 9/11. The second thing this slide shows is that there's a cure, and technology can be that cure. And my passion to see that transpire is very personal. These are my kids. I have a dream and a vision that by the time my son drives, we think about drunk driving like we think about polio. Something in the past. It's something that was. The reality of making that happen is occurring. There's an initiative, the Dad's Initiative. It's an initiative that's sponsored by the automotive industry and the National Highway Safety Transportation Administration. And they're financing companies to develop passive alcohol detection. It's exciting to see TrueTouch is one of two companies sponsored. Think about that. No more drunk driving fatalities in New Mexico. That would be fantastic. The last one is Verilite. What I want to do is pause for just a second. Have you looked to your side? Look at that person. Look at the other person. Odds are, sadly so, one of you will likely develop diabetes in the course of your lifetime. And if it's not detected and treated, you'll develop complications. Those complications are awful. They include amputation, blindness, and kidney failure. What we're doing with Verilite is we're taking the science fiction and now making it science reality. The tricorder of Star Trek, the device that diagnosed people non-invasively, is now a reality. That device you see there is launching September 19th. We're selling product. It's a device that measures or determines if you have diabetes non-invasively. Think of how much easier that will be to screen people so we avoid those complications. I want to talk briefly about Medici. It's kind of a return to the non-invasive glucose, where this activity really started. If you're a patient today that has diabetes, you have to take a barbaric instrument like that, stab your finger, to get a blood sample, to put on a strip. And amazingly so, you have to do that 1,000 times a year for the rest of your life. Ugh. There's a better way. It's a product like this. By simply putting some gel on the back of your hand, placing in it a device, we measure your glucose non-invasively, and it will lead to the elimination of finger sticks. So hopefully what I've done is I've shared with you my obsession with making light measurements, taking this technology and changing the world we live in. It's taken time, but it is occurring. Well, there are two things I wanted to cover. The first is that light measurements are becoming a reality. And the second is that one person's obsession can change the world. So I would encourage you to think about getting an obsession. Because what it does is it will cause you to act with purpose and to think with impact. And it may allow you to create an enduring legacy. So to finish, I have several questions. The first, have you ever had or do you have an obsession? The second is, what is it? Is it written down? That often makes things real. Is it written down? The third thing is, if it was fully realized, would the world be a better place? I see a few nods. So then I have to finish and ask the simple question, are you acting on that? And if not, why not?